Welcome, everyone, to Lesson 3 in our Biblical Foundations class. Lesson 3 is entitled, In the Beginning. Our memory verse for this lesson is Romans 5, 18 and 19. We'll be reading it from the New Living Translation. Read along as I read it out loud. Yes, Adam's one sin brings condemnation for everyone, but Christ's one act of righteousness brings a right relationship with God and new life for everyone. Because one person disobeyed God, many became sinners. But because one other person obeyed God, many will be made righteous. When we practice this later in class, we'll divide it into small sections and do a carousel like we've done before. So, as we've been saying, God, the Bible tells us, is the creator of the entire universe. And as we look at Genesis 1, we see a phrase over and over again. That phrase is, and God said. For example, in verse 3, and God said, let there be light. So God not only created the entire universe, he literally spoke the universe into existence. So as a creator, God has all rights over his creation. He can create and he can destroy. And also he can make the rules and determine what is right. God determines what is right by who he is, not so much by saying this is right and this is wrong, but by who he is. Everything that is godly is right, and everything that is not godly would be wrong. The Bible tells us also that God made humans differently than he made the rest of creation. In Genesis chapter 2, it says that he breathed life into mankind. God breathed his own life into us and gave us an eternal soul. He didn't do that for any of the rest of creation. Genesis 1, 26 and 27 says, let us make man in our image. So we are made in the image of God. The us there refers to the Trinity. There is one God, but he is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we are made in his likeness, which means that we have a heart, a soul, a mind, and a conscience. We have feelings and emotions. We have an eternal soul that will live forever. We have the ability to think and to reason, and we understand right and wrong. God also put us in charge of all creation. That doesn't mean the creation belongs to us. It still belongs to God. But God gave it over to us to use as we see fit, to watch over it, and to care for it.